Hello, and welcome to Vacation Bible School, and welcome to Concrete and Cranes. We are doing a virtual VBS this year, and we look forward to you being a part of that experience. Each night, we will have music and Bible story and be encouraged to walk through the foundations of Vacation Bible School and what it means to experience that in a whole new way. So, hope you enjoy Concrete and Cranes.
John 15:13 that says, "No one has greater love than this, to lay down his life for his friends."
I'm looking forward to learning more about that great love. So I guess we better put on our hard hats and get started. We're so happy you're here today.
Even when our hearts condemn us, greater is the God who's in us.
Hey, Pastor Ryan here, and I hope you are enjoying our vacation Bible school. I want to teach you our VBS motto and scripture. And every night we will have an opportunity to go over this. It'll be on the video, it'll be on Facebook, and you'll be learning this motto and scripture with us during our vacation Bible school. So here it is. It's on the screen. This is our motto. It's real simple. I'm going to say it once, and then I want you to say it with me. Here we go. Here's our motto. Jesus, our strong foundation. Say that with me. Jesus, our strong foundation. Now, here's what I want you to do. I want you to memorize that this week and be thinking about how Jesus is your strong foundation. All right, and here is our scripture. It's Philippians 1:8, and it says this, "I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus." I want you guys to be learning that this week, and every night we'll have an opportunity to hear that scripture again. Again, Philippians 1:8. Let's say it one more time together. "I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus."
Welcome back. It's day 3, halfway through the week. Can you imagine? It's been such a fast time going through the Bible stories, and now it's day three already. So, okay, let's go through our foundation. So, day one, we talked about the foundation of
love.
Day two, yesterday, we talked about the foundation of forgiveness. So today we have a new foundation. Our foundation today is the foundation of worth. Now, have you ever had something that was worth so much to you that you would do anything to keep it safe? Maybe it was a favorite toy. Maybe it was an electronic. Maybe it was your cell phone. Maybe it's a person. Things of great worth are things that we want to keep safe because they're special to us. They're important to us. And so today we're going to talk about how each and every one of you have that kind of worth to Jesus. See, he loves you like that. Like you're his favorite thing in the whole world. And that's the worth we're going to talk about tonight. Our Bible story tonight is coming from Matthew again. Matthew chapter 26 to be exact. And we're going to talk about Jesus tonight. So we talked about Matthew the first night, kind of about Jesus. And we talked about Paul last night and a little bit about Jesus. But tonight we're actually talking about Jesus himself and something that he did to prove to us how worthy we are to be his children. But before we get there, you know what we have to do first?
Lunch pail.
So let's see what's in our lunch pail today. Still not food. All right, here we go. Ooh. Inside my lunch pail today, I have four items. Your job is to tell me what the item is and what you use it for. Okay? All right, so here we go. First item.
Hammer.
A hammer. What would you use a hammer for?
Making toys.
Yeah, this does kind of look like an elf hammer, doesn't it? Like Santa's little helper. All right, that's one. The next one I have is this one.
Screwdriver.
Screwdriver. What do you use a screwdriver for?
Tighten screws.
Tighten screws.
Those would be screws.
Not nails.
Emily's not a carpenter. Next one.
Wrench.
Wrench. It's a wrench. Almost stumped you on that one. What do you use a wrench for?
Tighten bolts.
Tighten bolts. Look at you. Look at you. And the last one.
Pliers.
Pliers, specifically needle nose pliers. What do you use pliers for?
Wires.
Could, yep, to squeeze things or to twist things around, different things like that. So I have four tools in here. Each of these tools has a different job. Would you agree with that?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So they all are very important to somebody who's doing a job in construction. Because if I don't have a hammer, none of these tools can do the job of this one as well as this one can, right? Or my needle nose pliers, a hammer cannot do the same thing that pliers can do. So each one is important in its own way. So I'm going to give this to Ryan. There you go. Each one has a purpose. And in our story today, we're going to talk about how Jesus fulfilled his purpose on this earth and why he came in the first place. So here's our picture for today. And here we go. Jesus knew that he had come to earth to be the savior of the world. He knew that that meant that eventually he would have to die. On the last night Jesus spent with his disciples, he took them to a place called Gethsemane, which was a garden. And Jesus said to his men, "Sit here while I go and pray." Then Jesus asked Peter and two other disciples, James and John, to go a little farther into the garden with him. You see, Jesus was very sad and he was troubled because he knew that he was going to die on the cross to help save people from their sins. Jesus asked Peter, James, and John to stay awake with him because he was so, so troubled. When Jesus had gone a little further into the garden alone, he fell to his knees and he began to pray. He asked God if there was any other way to provide forgiveness other than by dying. You see, Jesus didn't want to disobey God, but he also knew that all things are possible for God. Jesus told God that he would do whatever God wanted him to do. So Jesus returned to Peter, James, and John, but you know what he found? Those three were sound asleep. Jesus said, "Couldn't you stay awake with me for just an hour? Stay awake and pray." So then Jesus went into the garden a second time to pray. And when he came back, guess what?
They're asleep again.
They were all asleep again because they just couldn't keep their eyes open. Finally, Jesus went alone into the garden a third time to pray. And when he returned, you guessed it, he found him asleep again. He told them to get up and go with him. Jesus knew that it was time to go with the soldiers and follow through with God's plan. He was willing to suffer and die on a cross to save us from our sins. So Jesus had a purpose. When he came to earth, he knew what his purpose was. His one purpose was to die on the cross for the salvation of everyone from their sins. So Jesus knew the plan for providing salvation and payment for sin was for him to die. He didn't ever have a question about that. He knew that it would be painful and that it would be heartbreaking. He asked if there was any other way, but God didn't say there was another way. Yet Jesus wanted to obey his Father and do what God wanted him to do. Jesus knew it was his time to go and follow through with God's plan to save us from our sins. So we have another verse for tonight, just like every other night. And this one comes from the book of John again, chapter 15, 13. And it says this, "No one has greater love than this, to lay down his life for his friends." And that's exactly what Jesus did for us. He loved us so much, just like we talked about on that first night with our foundation of love. And he wanted to prove that we were worth something to him, that we meant something to him, that we were special to him. And so by dying on the cross, he proved to everybody that we all had worth, that we all meant to be special in God's kingdom. And every single one of us has that same gift, no matter who we are. So today, remember, you have worth to God. He values you, and he wants you to be a part of his kingdom. So Ryan, why don't you close in prayer for the night?
All right. Well, before I close, this is day three, and I do want to remind you as we move through the night and through the week of Vacation Bible School that you will have an opportunity to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. And that's as simple as A, B, C. A, admit to God that you're a sinner. B, believe in Jesus as his son. And C, confess him as Savior and Lord. We'll be talking more about that as the week goes on and have a special time, an invitation time for you to respond to that at the end of the week. So let's pray together. Father God, we thank you so much for who you are. God, you are a good God who sent your son to do something special for us, to die in our place, a death that we deserved and he took in our place. And we're thankful for that. We're thankful for that sacrifice, that ultimate display of worth as our foundation in you. Father, thank you for your love and your forgiveness. And we pray as we continue to have fun this week during Vacation Bible School and continue to participate with the videos and the crafts and the Bible stories, we pray that you just speak into the lives of these kids as they watch these videos and learn more about your love for them. Father, we love you. We thank you. In your name we pray. Amen.
See you tomorrow.
Have a good week.
Hey, guys. Welcome back to day three. For your craft today, we have a metal cross. And in your activity book, we will turn to day three, which will be on page 6 and 7. Hope you guys are enjoying VBS. See you tomorrow.
Yes to VBS.
I learn my ABC.
How you gonna say yes to VBS?
By reading the Word of God.
How are you going to say yes to feed me yes?
By living